Welcome into this video, guys. Today I wanted to shoot this short video on some tips and tricks that I learned this past deer season and the things that were successful for me and the things that didn't work out. I want to go through a few things that I learned that I will carry into deer season next year. This video will be geared towards the experienced hunter along with the new hunter or the hunter that only has a few seasons under their belt. We want to speak to both groups as they go and prepare for next deer season. So let's dive on into this video and analyze my 2021 deer season. The first tip I have is don't be afraid to move. This hunt happened on September 28th of this past deer season, and I have to back up to the 24th. The 24th, I did an evening hunt down in Maryland, and I wanted to slip into a new area, and I ended up finding an apple tree. So I knew I wanted to sit there because the apples were under the tree and there's a lot of deer signs. So I knew that that's where they were. So I set up in there, and off to my left was a staging area. It was a low green grass field in the midst of this super thick stuff. So that evening I sat there, I ended up seeing a couple doe and a spike out in that staging area. The following day, which was a Saturday, the 25th, I slipped back down in there and I hunted the opposite side of that staging area due to the wind. I set up in a tree that was about 25 yards off of that staging area. And about 30 minutes before the end of shooting light, I had this nice 8-point come in and he was milling around out there. He was getting a little weary. And what ended up happening was my thermals were sucking down into that area and he smelled me and spun around and took off. The next day was Sunday, so I couldn't hunt. So then Monday, I slipped back in there and hunted an evening hunt. And I sat another tree on the tip of the staging area. So I was right on top of that staging area. I had deer come from that apple tree and come down through the thick stuff and were at 20 yards, but it was so thick I could never see what they were and I could obviously couldn't get a shot. So the following day, which was the 28th, I slipped back down in there for an evening hunt and I sat the same tree that I hunted the day before. This time I took my compound. I set up in there and deer just kind of started funneling out. There was a couple of fawns, then I had one moving across the hillside above me, and then I had a big doe step out of the thick stuff, and she was milling around out there, and up she got a little bit weary and started to go through the woods a little bit, and at 30 yards I punched through her and got a double lung, and she dropped within 50 yards. But that being said, me moving around that little area, learning where these deer are coming from and how they're moving into that staging area was key. I had those three hunts previous to my successful hunt that I was learning from, and I bounced around to each tree. And that's how I usually hunt. I don't necessarily like hunting the same tree twice, even if I have success. I like bouncing around, I like learning new spots, and I like seeing how those deer move into those areas. The next tip is you don't need the latest and greatest gear to have success. This next hunt happened on October 11th. All I had on this hunt was my recurve and myself. That's all I had. I went to my parents' house, not intending to hunt at all. I was actually going over there to target practice with my recurve. And I ended up getting out of the truck and realizing that I had a good wind and good weather to hunt their property. I had no cameras, I had no stands, I had no intel, I didn't know what was there, I hadn't hunted it in archery for years. At their property with historical knowledge, I knew where the deer bedded and I had a good idea of where they would move, but I didn't know exactly because I had done no scouting, I had no cameras, had no intel. So I ended up walking out into their field at 6:30 that evening and closing time was 6:55. I climbed a maple tree by hand, I was standing on a limb, and at 6:50, I heard a crunch behind me, and I looked back, and on the trail that I thought they might be on, there stands a very nice buck. It was a beautiful 8-point, my biggest buck to date, and it was the first buck and deer that I'd ever killed with my recurve. Very cool hunt, and being able to go out there with just my bow and have success was pretty crazy, just to show that you don't need the latest and greatest stuff to have success on a hunt. The third tip that I have is wait for the right opportunity. This hunt happened on November 2nd, down in Maryland on public land. I was bouncing around all morning to some different spots, and I came into a spot that Grant was actually hunting, and he had seen a couple bucks that morning, and I wanted to get down in there, so I got down into a little pinch point. The ravine really pinches down. There's bedding on both sides, and it really pinches down between two fields. And there's actually a creek, so it adds a little bit of a bluff there. I was sitting there, saw a couple of deer, saw a little 7-point as I was setting up. And about 1 o'clock, I saw a deer coming through the field, and it turned out to be a buck. He came right to me, and was about 6 or 7 yards in front of me, hard quartering too, and I decided I was going to take the shot. Looking back, I should have waited about 3 more seconds. He had no idea it was there, and he was starting to slightly turn, and he would have given me a broadside shot. I still got double lung. I got all the way through the deer, and he died quick. But for someone that maybe doesn't have the poundage of the bow or the length arrows that I do with all the kinetic energy and the extra length, they're going to have to wait for that broadside or quartering away shot. They're not going to be able to punch through that scapula and shoulder blade and get into the vitals of the deer. So if I would have waited about 3 more seconds, that deer would have been broadside, and I would have had a perfect angle right through the lungs, would have got a pass through, and he still would have died in 50 yards. But with that other shot, with a quartering two shot, it was a little bit more of a marginal shot. I could have hit hard bone and my arrow could have stopped. I could have hit in that spot where it's just a dead zone. In the moment, I just thought I could get through it, and I did, but for the average hunter, they might not be able to. So wait for that perfect opportunity to get that broadside or quartering away shot so you know you can get into those vitals with a good shot. The fourth tip is changes in weather are crucial. This hunt happened on November 13th up in Tioga County at Grant's Cabin. I had hunted a couple of days up there, and on Saturday the 13th, I woke up and it was raining, and I really didn't want to sit in the rain because I was just hunting for a doe because I had already filled my buck tag earlier in the season. So I waited until the rain was forecasted to stop, which was about 8 o'clock. So I got out there at 7:30, got up in the tree, set up my tree umbrella just for the drizzle and the drip of the rain off of the trees. And as soon as that rain stopped, deer started showing up. And it was the same for the day before. The snow had let up and the rain had let up. And sure enough, this really nice buck came walking through, and I had already punched my tag. And he walked through at about 35 yards, and just a beautiful 8-point. But then that following day, the 13th, I was set up right after the snow, and sure enough, here comes a doe, right as expected, right after that weather changed. She came right through, stopped at 20 yards, and I went in a little high, but dropped her in her tracks. I was able to follow up pretty quick and make it a clean kill. It was just really cool to see how those weather changes affected those deer. Those deer don't really like moving in the rain and the snow, but as soon as that snow lets up, they want to be on their feet because they need to get to food, especially if it's been snowing and raining all night. First thing in the morning, those deer are going to be moving with that change in the weather. The next tip I have is get off the beaten path. This hunt happened on November 28th up in Potter County. It was the second day of the PA rifle season. I was walking up a ridge that I have had success on in the past. I got about 3/4 of the way up, which is about 3/4 of a mile. It's a long ridge, really steep benches. There's benches, and then it really starts to increase, and it kind of flattens out again and just keeps going up through for about a mile. So I'm about 3/4 of the way up that ridge, and I really wanted to drop down on the side hill, really steep side hill, and it was kind of treacherous because there was snow on the ground. So, and there's slate and shale underneath, so you don't know where you're stepping, and it can be difficult to side hill. But as I'm going out through this mountain laurel and rhododendron, I cut a set of tracks and I saw a bed. Now I'm down in here deep. There's not many people that want to do that. They don't want to get on those side hills in fears of slipping and falling, which I totally understand, but that's where the deer were. They had found a little bench in there, and that's where they were bedded, and I knew it was fresh. Kind of going back to the last tip where the weather had changed that morning. It had snowed all night long, and as soon as that snow let up, those deer were out of their beds and heading for food. And I knew that, and I knew where the food was. So I found their beds, and I started tracking in that fresh snow. I didn't go more than 100 yards, and I saw the deer standing another 100 yards ahead of me. And I took a shot, and I missed, and it ran uphill, and I started running to a tree, got to a tree, and settled in on it and squeezed one off and ended up getting it. But being able to get off that beaten path into that steep, thick cover where those deer were and finding their beds was crucial to me having success on that hunt. Another thing that was crucial on that hunt, I had snow. If I didn't have snow, I never would have seen that deer. And be able to see where they were, find their beds, find their tracks, and know exactly where they were heading was crucial to me getting that deer down on the ground. The sixth and final tip that I have is don't be afraid to be aggressive. This hunt happened on January 17th. I was down in Maryland on some public land hunting with Cameron, and we were in a spot where We have had success in the past doing drives late season. So basically what it is it's a square piece of timber, and on the top side of it, it kind of wraps around and pinches up into a little valley. The woods line pinches up. So they bet on that top edge, and Cameron was coming around the east side of that, and I was on the west side. So I came into that little valley where it pinches up, and I got in there real quick because I knew that when he came around that corner, he was gonna be bumping deer out of that bedding. And sure enough, he did. He had shot me a text saying that he was starting the drive, and literally about 2 to 3 minutes later, I saw him coming out through the thick stuff. Now, I'm on one side of the ravine, and they're on the other. The ravine isn't that big, but they were still probably 70, 80 yards ahead of me. So I had no shot. So what I ended up having to do is, I didn't want to be passive and sit there and not get a shot. So I ended up doing is letting those deer pass me, and I got on a trail on my side of the ravine because I knew that they were going to parallel the creek in the bottom. So I started paralleling the deer as well because the ravine started to pinch, and I knew that their track and my track were going to pinch together too. So I really got low and just started moving. And I was on that trail, and I went about 60 yards, and I happened to catch a glimpse of the doe at 20 yards beside me. And I knew that if I stopped, I would not get a shot because that deer would know something's up if I stopped. But since I was on a hiking trail, they knew that I was probably just a hiker and they were just gonna let me pass. So I ended up drawing my bow as I'm walking and just kept walking until I was able to get a lane. I just kept peeking over to make sure I had a lane, or if I didn't have a lane. And if I didn't have a lane, I just kept moving. And I went maybe another 10, 15 yards, and I was kind of circling around because she was facing me, so I didn't want to take that shot. So I ended up getting around the deer, finding an opening, and I let one fly. I did hit her a little bit back, but I ended up clipping an artery, and she died within 30 yards. I saw her crash. And it was just a really fun hunt. I had never stalked a deer like that on the ground and was successful with the bow. That being said, being aggressive led to that success. If I was passive and just stayed sitting where I was, I never would have got those deer because they were staying about 70 to 80 yards ahead of me on the other side of the ravine. I would have just let them walk right by me and I never would have had a shot. But me being aggressive and trying to catch up to those deer and cut them off was the key for me having success in that hunt. So those are the six things that I learned and think are crucial for every hunter out there. They're not necessarily the best tips for being the better hunter, but they're great tips that maybe some people don't think about. I think these tips can lead to more success, and I also think they can lead to seeing more deer. Not every hunt that I don't kill a deer is a failure. I learn something on every hunt, and I killed 6 deer this year, but I probably had 30, 35 hunts. So there's a lot of hunts in there that I didn't kill a deer, but yet I learned something, and that's what led to the successful hunts that I did have. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to our channel. There's hundreds of other hunting videos, fishing videos, any outdoors things. We try and do a little bit of everything to appeal to the majority of outdoorsmen. We want to appeal to the everyday outdoorsman, and that is you guys out there watching this video. Your continued support really helps us to continue what we're doing. We enjoy being out in the woods. We enjoy creating content. We love your feedback, so don't hesitate to reach out. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we'll see you on the next one.